Okay.
So welcome to day two of the Africa unit. And here we're looking at the life as a hunter activity. So we're picking up on the idea that we saw and we briefly discussed from the last time we met, that how hunting and living in a group can be more efficient than if you do it solo. Okay, and the organism that was hunting in a group was the lion, as you saw when it chased down the baby water buffalo as a group and caught it. And then your solo hunter that you saw was the crocodile, where it was just one crocodile acting independently, trying to get the water buffalo from the lions. So we're gonna investigate from a calorie standpoint and an energy standpoint why it's more efficient to hunt as a group. So in this activity, you guys are gonna consider the cost of hunting and the benefit of each potential prey type animal. You're going to use evidence to explain how much energy is needed to be spent and received from hunting certain organisms. And you're gonna see this in terms of the total energy cost to hunt and kill, and then the total energy gained per kill for each of the different organisms. So we have a couple different organisms that we're looking at. We're looking at meerkats, warthogs, wildebeests, and zebras. Okay, and you can see that each one has a mass, so that's how heavy they are. This is how much energy the lion has to expend to kill it. And then this is how much energy is gained when it does kill it. Okay, so what you can see right off the bat is the organism that gives you the most amount of energy per kill is the zebra. But the zebra also has a big energy cost, 55,000 kcals of energy. So it's a trade-off. It takes a lot to kill it, but you also gain a lot. All right, so I'm going to start up here at the top paragraph, and you guys can read along with me. But it says, life is challenging for a female lion in Etosha National Park. So that's a national park in Africa. If a female's body size is approximately 130 kilograms, she must consume 13,500 kcals per day to survive and succeed. There are plenty of prey species available, but just living and breathing costs a significant amount of energy per day. This means that she will use energy just to rest and stay alive. Organisms then use more energy for different activities throughout the day, including hunting. Female lions have approximately 15,000 kcals stored. So when hunting, they must use less than 15,000 kcals for each hunt. Listed to the right are four species lions will hunt, along with the energy costs and gains to hunting each type of food source. So here's what we do in round one. So round one is you're tracking a female lion, and you have to determine how many of each prey species she would need to successfully hunt and consume each day to gain the amount of energy she needs. So just looking back at the numbers, she must consume 13,500 kcals per day to survive. And they have 15,000 kcals stored. Okay, so that means that they have to use less than 15,000 kcals for each hunt. So if we look at the first two questions, how much energy does a lion need to survive? 13,500 kcals per day. And a kcal is a kilocalorie. A calorie is a unit of energy. So a kilocalorie is, you know, 1,000 calories. So 13,500 kcals per day is an energy amount. How much energy does a lion have to spend? So this is the stored amount that we just talked about. It's 15,000 kcals. Okay, so let's look just at the meerkat. So table, okay, we're gonna do the meerkat one together just to give you a sense of how to do it. Okay, so keeping in mind these two values, how much energy the lion needs to survive per day and how much total energy cost, or how much they have to spend, per day. You can think of that as like their bank account. Like you only have 15,000 kcals in your bank, so you can't spend anything more and you can't go down to zero. You have to leave something in your bank account. So with that knowing, or with that understood, we know a meerkat costs, we know a meerkat costs negative 3,000 kcals to hunt. So one meerkat is negative 3,000 kcals. Okay, so think of it like this. If I can spend 15,000 kcals, what's the minimum amount of meerkats I can hunt down and kill? You might think, oh, I can hunt and kill five, right? Because that'll take me to 15,000 and that's how much I have to spend. Remember though, you can't spend all of it. You got to leave some in the reserve. So instead of five, you can hunt and kill four. So if you hunt and kill four meerkats, what's the total energy cost? Well, it's four times negative 3,000, which is negative 12,000 kcals. Okay? Now, how much energy is gained per kill? So the energy gained per one kill is this value right here, positive 5,000. Okay, now if I kill four meerkats as a lion, and each one gives me 5,000 units of energy, kcals, what would be the total energy gain from this hunt? Well, 4 times 5,000 is 20,000 kcals. So if I kill four meerkats, I'm going to get 20,000 units of energy, 20,000 kcals. But there's a cost to this, right? That's how much we gained, but how much did we expend when we hunted those meerkats? And this is what column 6 is looking at. Column 6 asks for the net energy gained in kcals. So, yes, we gained 20,000, but how much did we spend? We spent a total of 12,000. So the net asks you to basically find the difference between the two. So we gained 20,000, but we spent 12,000. So 20,000 minus 12,000 equals 8,000 units of energy. So 8,000 kcals. Now, is that enough for us as a lion, as a female lion, to survive for that day? How many kcals do you need per day to survive? Okay, it's this value right here, which is the same value that we wrote in right here. So you need 13,500 kcals per day to survive. Did we get that by hunting down four meerkats? No. So is this a worthwhile species to hunt on your own? No, it is not. Okay, so you guys have to go through and do the warthog, wildebeest, and zebra and come up with the conclusions here for hunting on your own. Now, you might find that, you know, the meerkats are pretty easy to hunt on your own because they don't cost a lot of energy. But you might run into some organisms where you're unable to hunt them on your own, and that's okay. It might make filling out the table a little bit easier, okay? But when you're done with the table, you want to go through these questions. So questions 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, okay? You want to answer them. Now, we are going to, for right now, we're going to skip the performance assessment. So we're going to skip it. We're going to skip it. We're going to skip it. And we go right to round 2. Okay, now round 2 is a little bit harder. Round 2 says that lions live in prides, and depending on their sex, size, and age, lions have different kcal per day requirements. The pride you are following consists of one male, four females, and three juveniles. So males require more kcals per day than what we saw for females. Okay, you can see the difference there. And then juveniles, because they're tinier, they're smaller, they require even less kcals per day than a female would. Okay, so keeping into account these numbers, this is the little pride that you're following, and the amount of kcals per day, it's going to help you answer 10. Okay, so for 11, after you've answered 10, but for 11, who hunts for the pride? So the pride, and this is how it works for all of your lion prides, it's the female. Okay, so the female hunts for the pride. So females. And so in looking at this pride, how many hunters do you have? You have 4. How much energy can each hunter spend on hunting? Okay, if you recall all the way back up from the top, it's 15,000 kcals. So we can answer 11C together. How much total energy do we have available to hunt per day? So if we have 4 females and each female provides 15,000 kcals, it's 4 times 15,000. What is 4 times 15,000? We got 60,000 kcals to hunt. So we got a little bit more in our bank now for round 2. Okay? So if we look at 13, 13 says, what combination of prey items should your pride attempt to catch so that the entire pride has enough energy to survive? Make sure that you spend less than 15,000 per hunter. Fill in the table. Okay, we're going to make this table a little bit easier to understand based on the values that we have. For 13, it says, what combination of prey items should your pride attempt to catch so that the entire pride has enough energy to survive? Make sure you spend less than 15,000 per hunter. So I don't want you to think of it as spending less than 15,000 per hunter. I want you to just think of this as spending less than what we calculated from 11C. So 60,000 kcals. Okay? Now, you need your answer that you got from 10, and I'm holding back on giving you the answer there because I want you to at least do a little bit of work on round 2. The answer that I just boxed up here is the total energy that your pride needs to survive per day. So the net energy that you calculate right here for this yellow or tannish box, this needs to be greater than that box. Okay, so your net energy for your pride has to be greater than the total amount of energy that the pride needs. Okay, you can make it equal to, I'll allow that, but you also can go greater than. So essentially, what you guys get to do for this table is you get to come up with your own menu, if you will, of different organisms that you saw from round 1. So you have your meerkat, your warthog, your wildebeest, and your zebra. Okay, if you want to hunt all meerkats, and now since you have a larger energy bankroll to work with, you can hunt more meerkats than what we saw before. If you think that will work, you can try it out, punch in your numbers, and see if you get it. Okay, if you want to do a combination, like maybe 3 warthogs, 1 wildebeest, and a zebra, if you have enough energy for that, punch it in, see if you can do it. I mean, I'll give you a hint. If you did 1 warthog, 1 wildebeest, and 1 zebra, that's 5,000 plus 10,000 plus 15. So that brings you to 70,000 units of energy. Is that going to be enough to take down, or is that too much energy cost or too much energy expended? Well, you only have 60,000 kcals to work with, and just with that combination, you know, you used 70,000, so that's too much. So remember, you can use less than 60,000 kcals of energy. You cannot use more than. So it's up to you guys to find what the right prey species would be to hunt, or what combination of prey species to hunt would be. And you use this table to fill it out. And your end goal, remember, is to have a larger net energy gained than what your pride needs to survive per day. Okay. All right. So this is what you're working on in class, or during this asynchronous time. We will have some time on the following week when we meet next to go through questions. You'll have a little bit of time at the beginning to kind of finalize your work and to make sure everything looks good, and to ask questions if they're there. Okay? I hope this helped. Email me if you get stuck as you're working on this. I will be checking email. I can help you guys out from a distance here. Okay?